want your heirs to fight over your wealth after you leave, well, go and study the lives of the wealthy. A lot of them across the globe, their wealth is being scrounged upon by their own heirs whom they have left behind. Some of them, brothers and sisters, who have stopped speaking to one another solely because the father was a rich man. Now that he passed away, they are fighting over his wealth. Better than all that would be if I could donate a little charity, and I could teach my children to be donating as well and charitable people. For indeed, if I leave a child whom I have taught goodness, it will be of benefit for me. As you know, the narration of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clearly says that a person who passes away, their deeds are cut off except for three. What are those three? A little child of theirs who prays for them, a charitable deed that continues in reward, or a piece of knowledge that they have imparted. May the Almighty make us from any one of those three, and may He grant us from amongst those three. For indeed, my brothers and sisters, today we have a notion that when someone passes away, we should all make dua for that person. Yes, we should. Sometimes, after a person passes away, people will build a masjid on his name. People will drill boreholes on his name or her name. The question I have, what did you do in your life? That is the question. Why did you wait to die for others to do it on your name? Do it whilst you're alive. Allahu Akbar. You want to drill the boreholes? Get them done now. You want to do something, build a masjid? Get it done now. You want to be benevolent? Go ahead now. Don't wait to die and then people do it on your behalf. One wonders how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at those deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. People ask a question. We want to read Quran because someone has passed away. Well, if they themselves never ever read the Quran, how then are you going to benefit them? If someone did not pray himself or herself, we will ask Allah to forgive them. But you cannot now pray on their behalf and say, you know what, I will fulfill all the prayers that this person did not pray. If that was the case, would it be right for us to declare the Shahada in place of someone who did not declare it in their lives? No. No soul shall shoulder the burden of another. We need to know this. And this is why the Almighty is most merciful, most forgiving. Brothers and sisters, impart some goodness. If there is anything good you are planning to do, do it today. Don't wait for tomorrow. You may never see tomorrow. If there is anything bad you are planning to quit, quit it today. Whether it is a habit of a cigarette or a shisha or whatever else it is, that is considered minor by some, yet they are not minor. They are dangerous not only for your health, but even for your spirituality and your body. And for the day you meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would you be proud of the fact that you have smoked away 500,000 boxes of Marlboro in your life? May Allah protect us. With that amount of money, perhaps we might have been able to assist 5,000 refugees who do not have homes today in Palestine. My brothers and sisters, let's reach out to one another. And one of the best points we can say, reach out to yourself. Reach out to the good inside you. Every one of us is made up of a lot of good and sometimes a little bit of bad as well. Some of us allow the bad to dominate in such a way that nobody can see the good in us. And some of us allow the good to dominate such that it eclipses the bad. I call on you and myself today to increase the good and to decrease the bad. Make it your business and mine to prepare for the day you meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why I started with a narration where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks of al-kayyis, an intelligent person, an intellect, a sound, sharp person. Who is he? Is he the one who has a PhD, who can outwit others, perhaps who can outdo others in terms of work and salary and so on? The hadith says, man dana nafsa. He is the one who recognizes who he is. He recognizes himself and he does deeds which will help him after death. An intelligent person is he who recognizes himself. How would you recognize yourself? Ask yourself, if I am 40 years old, for example, where was I 45 years ago? Don't stop until you find an answer. And then ask yourself, where are those who have passed away last year and the previous year? Where did they go? And ask yourself, can I avoid going where they went? You will answer these questions. And when you answer them, you will come to realize that life is so short that people who are more powerful than us They had bigger physical build. They also died, and today they are not even available for us to speak to. هل تحس منهم من أحد أو تسمع لهم ركزا? Do you feel any one of them? Any one of them? Do you feel their presence here? Or can you even hear a slight sound of theirs? They were more powerful than you, and they had much more wealth than you. They have all gone to meet their maker. So am I, and so are you. There will come a day, 100 years from today, when nobody will know that we existed. There will come a time when our great-grandchildren will not even know our name. Do you know that? And evidence for that, how many of you know your fifth-generation grandfather? I think very few. Very few. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. So in the same way that 5 years before birth, we were not to be mentioned, perhaps 100 years after death, the bulk of us will never ever be mentioned again. Even our own progeny will never know that we existed. They might know that somewhere, somehow, I had a grandfather who came from this region of the world, but they won't be able to pinpoint. And the evidence for that is we, beyond a certain point, cannot pinpoint it. Do you know what? As the years are passing, we are becoming more and more oblivious of who our fathers and grandfathers were. We are becoming people who are not even bothered with our own relatives, and we don't even know that this person is related to me. Yet we are supposed to be fulfilling their rights and duties. We are supposed to be looking after one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. Brothers and sisters, I have spoken, and I have tried to answer a question. If this was your last day, what would you do? How would you change your life? Brothers and sisters, repent for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for I seek repentance as well. And I ask the Almighty to forgive me.